Jermell Charlo finally responds to Terence Crawford and calls him out for all of the faking and bluffing that he been doing, trying to build his name off of all of the top PBC fighters. Before we get into this next video, make sure that y'all hit my like button and subscribe to the channel if you not already subbed to the channel. And remember, the like button is free, it don't cost you nothing, so quit hating and hit the like button. What's happening with it, y'all? So this past weekend, we all know that Bud Crawford, he fought David I've Been Sneezing. But the whole time leading up to the David I've Been Sneezing fight, all Terence Crawford was doing was talking about PBC fighters. In particular, Errol Spence, and even more than Errol Spence, he was talking about Jermell Charlo. Every interview he did, he was bringing up Jermell Charlo and how he gonna beat the hell out of Jermell Charlo and what he gonna do to Jermell Charlo. But the thing is the way that he conducted business with the PBC shows that Bud was only bluffing. He has no real intentions on moving up fighting Jermell Charlo. I mean, if he had real intentions on moving up fighting Jermell Charlo, wouldn't he have done business in good faith with the PBC? Nah, he didn't do that. He actually did the worst business possible that he could do with the PBC. It actually looks like that he sabotaged the business with PBC so he'll have an excuse why they don't want to work with him anymore. You know what I'm saying? That's what it looked like to me if we go over everything that he did leading up in the negotiations and then after the negotiations with the PBC trying to make the Errol Spence fight. But till this day, Bud Crawford is still talking about moving up in weight and fighting Jermell Charlo. I mean, it sounds good, but do we really believe him? And Jermell Charlo don't believe him. You know what I'm talking about? He's been talking about Jermell Charlo and beating Jermell Charlo ass for a couple years now. But what has Terence Crawford done to actually make that possibility realistic? I mean, what has he done? Everybody with common sense know that PBC wants him and Errol Spence fight before anything. So if you ain't willing to fight Errol Spence, if you making all these demands and then when they give you everything that you want and you back out of the Errol Spence fight to go run and do a fight with David I've Been Sneezing, right? You doing all of that. How are you supposed to fight Jermell Charlo? Wasn't you the one saying that you was going to walk through Errol Spence and then you was going straight up to 154 and fight Jermell Charlo? You haven't been doing nothing you said you was going to do. You do the complete opposite. You fight a nobody, somebody that nobody knows. I mean, Jermell Charlo and Errol Spence said they never even heard of this guy that you fight. And the way that you went about things after you took the fight, during the time that you were supposed to be negotiating with the PBC, how you never even told the PBC that you was negotiating with another company to see what they could come up with. But you was telling the other company the whole time everything that was going on between you and the PBC. You know what I'm saying? Private information, things that was going on during negotiations between you and the PBC. But then you expect us to believe that you actually want to go and work with the PBC and make fights with Errol Spence and Jermell Charlo? Dog, we don't believe you. What I'm going to do is I'm going to play y'all the audio footage and let y'all hear what Jermell Charlo had to say about this dude himself.
I just wanted to know if you had any thoughts on Crawford saying that, you know, eventually when he does fight you, he'll beat you pretty easily, and probably just like your overall thoughts on him beating Avanesian via 6-round knockout.
Now, I didn't get to see his fight. I've never heard of what he's done. I never heard of his opponent. I've been really focused on what I got in front of me, and I'm not even worried. Man, everybody say they're going to beat somebody this and that. Man, I don't say, all I see is him riding off the names of the PBC fighters. Like, he ain't even trying to really fight nobody for real. These people over here is a whole different ball field. You know what I'm saying? He playing in the AFL. I'm NFL. Top tier, gold, got the all the rings. I'm Tom Brady, the black one.
And so that's what Jermell Charlo had to say. Like I said, Jermell Charlo don't believe him. Jermell Charlo think the dude is just a clown and he just bluffing. You know what I'm saying? You doing all of this talking, right? Using the biggest names over on PBC to build your shit up. But when it comes down to it, you fighting Rudy Poot after Rudy Poot. You got one credible opponent on your whole resume, and that's Sean Porter. You know what I'm saying? And Sean Porter had one foot in and one foot out of the sport. That he knew he was going to retire after that he fought you. Matter of fact, he said he knew he was going to retire after he fought Errol Spence. And for those who want to come up in here talking about, oh, well, he fought Gamboa and he fought Cale Brook. Well, Gamboa, 5'3" and moved up in weight to fight Terence Crawford. Cale Brook hadn't fought at the weight in 3 years, didn't have his trainer, had to train himself because his trainer refused to train him because he said he wasn't going to train Cale Brook because he didn't have enough time with only 5 weeks of training. And he advised Cale Brook not to take the fight on that shorter notice. You know what I'm talking about? So don't even come in here with that bullshit. I'm going to give you credit for the Sean Porter, but none of them other dudes, come on, man. Just like Jermell Charlo said, man, he in the NFL and you still in the AFL. You feel me? And then it just sickened me how all y'all run around talking about how he's pound for pound number one and he's doing this and doing that. And that's the main reason why he's picking guys like David I've Been Sneezing to fight so he could look spectacular and all his fans in the boxing world gonna run around and say, see, that's why Terence Crawford is this and that's why Terence Crawford is that. But can you do that against top A-class competition? You don't even believe that you can. That's why you continue to fight the low-level competition that you've been fighting. You know what I'm talking about? So, man, we don't believe you. You know what I'm saying? And I would believe, but if he had a done business the right way with the PBC, even if he had a went to him and said, you know what? I want to still do business with you guys, but I just want to get this tune up in. And if y'all cool with it, you know what I'm saying? If y'all cool with still doing business after that, I would love to make fights with y'all down the line. But he didn't do that because he really didn't want to smoke with the top guys that they got at PBC. He just did that shit so it can sound good in the media. So people can say, oh man, well, Terence Crawford tried. He tried. You know what I'm saying, man? This dude is all bullshit. He's bluffing. He's the boy who cried wolf. Nobody believes you. You need more people. You feel me? And like I said, man, Jermell Charlo and Errol Spence, they're going to continue doing their thing. They're going to continue to fight the best of the best in their division or whatever divisions that they move up to. And you're going to continue doing what you do. Fighting Rudy Poots like you've been doing your whole life. Look at this man's whole resume. He's the best pound for pound. I mean, how you beat a bunch of C-class fighters and washed-up fighters and then run around and everybody call you the best pound for pound? It's a whole lot of motherfuckers that got great boxing skills. And I'm not saying that Terence Crawford don't have really good boxing skills and he don't do things really well in the ring. You know what I'm talking about? Look at Jerron Boosinis. Does that mean that Jerron Boosinis is the best pound for pound? No, people don't call Jerron Boosinis the best pound for pound because he ain't fought nobody yet. Just like you ain't fought nobody yet. Or I ain't even gonna use the word nobody. But just like you ain't fought another A-level fighter in they prime. You never have nowhere close to it. People don't call Gervonta Tank Davis the best fighter pound for pound in the sport. You know why? Because he hasn't fought the best yet. Errol Spence, he's fought the best. Keith Thurman has fought the best. We got other guys like, you know, Tyson Fury and Deontay Wilder. They didn't fought the best. How are they calling you the best pound for pound fighter in the world? Even Vasyl Lomachenko, in his heyday, he was fighting the best. Floyd Mayweather fought the best. Roy Jones fought the best. Andre Ward fought the best. Terence Crawford ain't fought nowhere near the best. Anyway, let me know what y'all think about this. Drop a comment in the comment section and make sure that y'all hit the like button and sub to the channel if you're not already a subscriber to the channel. Y'all already know how I do. There you go, talking that boxing again, and I'm gone. Choking on that leader, 2 miles per hour.